बशीर जी दिल कॉल योर नेम।
हाँ तो बोलेंगे तो दो दो मिनट, जो विषय है रूल 72 के तहत ही बोलोगे ना आप, नियम कानून के तहत ही बोलोगे ना। हाँ बोलिए
सर। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग मी अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रेज एन ऑब्जेक्शन ऑन दिस डार्विनियन लॉ व्हिच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट। सर फंडामेंटली दिस इज एन अटैक ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। बेसिकली व्हेन वी आर talking about the constitutions, this bill is a fundamental attack on constitution. So see sir, as per the provision, clearly composition of the central waqf council, basically the central waqf, where the waqf property is coming sir, that is coming from the donations of the believers, those who are believe in the god, and those who are be that they are giving the waqf donations. Now, Article 26 is very clear, sir. Freedom of to manage religious affairs, subject to public order, morality and health. Every religious denomination of any section thereof shall have the right to establish and maintain institution for religious and charitable purposes, to manage this own affairs in matters of religion, to own and acquire movable and immovable property, and to administer such property in accordance with law. This is Article 26 of the Constitution, sir. This bill, through this bill, they are putting a proviso that non-Muslims also be the member of the governing council. Shame. Sir, whether, shame. Sir, whether, through you, sir, I would like to ask a question to the government. Whether we think about the Supreme Court constitute the Board of Ayodhya, whether anybody can think that a non-Hindu be the part of Ayodhya Mandir, board, sir? Sir, we are believing in, sir, I told that. Guruvayu temple, there is a temple Devasam board. Anybody can believe that, that temple Devasam board can a non-Hindu? Sir, this is only, this provision, anybody, non-Muslims also be part of Waqf Council, is correctly an attack on the faith and freedom of religion. Correctly. Sir, that we are talking about the, you are telling we are the constitution. When we are showing the constitution, you are telling you people are protecting the constitution. This is a fundamental attack on constitution. This bill is a fundamental. Now you are going for Muslims. Next you will go for Christians. Next you will go for Jains. Next you will go for Parsi. Next you will go for. Therefore, there is a fundamental principle. You cannot go with the Hindu. There in our tradition, what is the tradition of Indian? What is the culture of Indian? That means, we are believing the culture and tradition of Indian, Bharat. Respect each other's faith. I told you, we are Hindu, sir. We are a believer, but we same time we are respecting the faith of other religions also. That is the basic principle. You want this bill is specialized for Maharashtra Haryana election. Yeah. This bill is specialized, but you don't understand that. Last time people of India clearly taught a lesson to you. This type of divisive politics India people will not going to buy now. Now again you are trying to experiment that bill, sir. Againly. This is an attack on federal system also. This is a clear attack on federal system also. Waqf properties, there's actually the nitty-gritty of that things dealing by the states, rules and the data collection, everything. This bill is take away all the data collection to the central side. The attack on constitutional freedom of religion, attack on federal system. Answer three, sir, basically the three. Sir, clearly, waqf by use, there is a concept of waqf by use. You see that near Delhi Parliament, there is a big, there is a mosque, more than 200 years old mosque. Nobody know that how it become, what was actually the property deal of that mosque itself. You are removing the clause of waqf by use through this amendment. That means There is going to be dispute in each and every mosque where there is no deal, deed. What will be the happen? Your fundamental idea is to create conflict and create the anger between the communities and make violence everywhere. Okay, I can understand if you want a prospective bill on this cross. There is still bit of justification. Retrospectively, you are taking over all the pilgrim centers which have no deed. There were traditional ages only. Every legislation, there should be a motive of, there should be an intention of well-being. That is what we are witnessing. That should come from the heart. Every legislation has to come from the ruler's duty is to make the decision which come from the heart. Now you are ill motive to divide the people of this country. That is why we bring the bill. Therefore, we are totally objecting the bill. This bill cannot be passed, sir. This bill cannot be introduced, sir.
Sri Mohi Bulla.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Janabe Sadr, मैं आपकी तवज्जो इस तरफ चाहता हूं आपके माध्यम से कि मैं वाहिद आदमी हूं इस सदन में जिसमें वन मैन कमेटी आपके द्वारा बनाई गई सरकार के और मैं उसमें पेश हुआ 123 प्रॉपर्टी में। जस्टिस आर्यन ने जो रिपोर्ट पेश की आज तक वक्फ बोर्ड को नहीं बताया गया चूंकि वो आपकी मंशा के खिलाफ थी और गवर्नमेंट की मंशा के मुताबिक नहीं थी। 123 प्रॉपर्टी में जब मंशा के खिलाफ हमारे नहीं आए, मंशा के मुताबिक नहीं आई, तो हमने टू मैन कमेटी बनाई और टू मैन कमेटी ने भी कोई रिपोर्ट वक्फ बोर्ड को नहीं दी, जबकि वक्फ एक्ट जो है 1995 जो है वो पार्लियामेंट से पास शुदा है कि हम पार्लियामेंट के जो एहतराम है उसका नहीं कर रहे, उसके हुकूक का। इसी तरह से सर सूबाई हुकूमतों को इख्तियार दिया गया। सर हिंदू एंडोमेंट में जो कर्नाटका और तमिलनाडु में है वहां कोई मुस्लिम नहीं हो सकता, और 26 में आर्टिकल 26 का वायोलेशन है। चार धाम में ये लिखा हुआ वाजे तौर पर कि सिर्फ हिंदू होगा। बिहार उड़ीसा में भी यही लिखा हुआ है। पंजाब हरियाणा में गुरुद्वारा प्रबंधक कमेटी में सिर्फ सिख होगा ओनली, और ये उनका अधिकार है जिसको माना गया है, लेकिन मुस्लिम के साथ में यह अन्याय क्यों है? और सुन लीजिए सर, सर मैं आपकी तवज्जो की चाहता हूं, दुनिया का सबसे पहला वक्फ खाने काबा मक्के में है, क्या हम उसके ऊपर भी सवाल उठाएंगे कि वहां पर भी हमारा कोई हिंदू भाई हो? हम अपने वकार को, अपने इज्जत को, अपने मुल्क की, अपने शान को, अपने संविधान को खुद अपने पैरों तले रौंद रहे हैं। और वक्फ एक मुसलमानों का मजहबी अमल है, एक मजहबी फरीजा है, इससे उनको महरूम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के जरिए से भी कोई ताकत नहीं कर सकती। सर ये हम बहुत बड़ी गलती करने जा रहे हैं जिसका खमियाजा हमें अभी नहीं सदियों तक हम भुगतते रहेंगे, क्योंकि हम खुद अपने कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को, संविधान को उसकी पवाली कर रहे हैं। अगर हमें इस सिलसिले में, मैंने सर पूरा पूरा मैंने उसको माध्यम से पढ़ा है और मैंने पूरी 40 तरामीम जो उसमें गलत है उसको लिखकर जो है वो मैं लेकर आया हूँ। सर इसके जरिए से सरकारी अमले को बाजाबता तौर पर यह हक आखिर तो कलेक्टर को दिया जा रहा है, सर्वे कमिश्नर के इख्तियारात खत्म किए जा रहे हैं। आखिर सर्वे कमिश्नर भी तो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का होता है। सर ऐसे कैसे कर सकते हैं हम? और फिर सर उसमें मेरे मजहब के मुतालिक चीजें हैं तो वो कैसे कोई दूसरा तय करेगा? क्या कुरान में क्या लिखा है, फिका में क्या लिखा है, इस्लाम में क्या लिखा है, ये आप तय करेंगे या मैं तय करूंगा? सर इससे हम मजहब में दखलंदाजी कर रहे हैं, इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ द रिलीजन कर रहे हैं। सर इस तरह के कानून से मुल्क की शाख को नुकसान पहुंचेगा, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन की स्प्रिट हम खत्म कर देंगे, और अगर ये होगा तो कोई भी अकलियत, कोई भी माइनॉरिटी अपने आप को हिंदुस्तान में सेफ नहीं पहुंच सेफ नहीं करेगी। पिछले दिनों सिखों के साथ भी ये हुआ और कुछ ईसाई भाइयों के साथ भी इस तरह के वाकयात हुए हैं, जिसकी वजह से सब लोग अपने आप को असहाय महसूस कर रहे हैं। 10 साल से जो मुल्क में माइनॉरिटीज के साथ, उनके हकूक के साथ, उनके रिलीजन फ्रीडम के साथ जो खिलवाड़ किया जा रहा है उससे रूह कांप जाती है और दिल ऐसा महसूस होता है कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि जनता इन हुकूक के लिए, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को बचाने के लिए दोबारा सड़कों पर आ जाएगी। सर
रूल 72 के तहत
ये विषय है, इसलिए मेरा आपसे आग्रह,
समर्थकों के लिए एक बिल लेके आए,
मैं इससे आग्रह करता हूँ कि संक्षिप्त में अपनी बात को रखें। श्री सुदीप बंदोपाध्याय, आपका नंबर।
सर, आई विल बी ब्रीफ। माय कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी इन सिटी कोलकाता, आई हैव यूज्ड नंबर ऑफ मुस्लिम्स एंड फुल ऑफ वॉक ऑफ प्रॉपर्टीज एंड एवरीथिंग। आई एम लिटिल अवेयर, आई विल स्पीक ओनली फ्यू पॉइंट्स, दैट इट इज अ वायलेटिव ऑफ आर्टिकल 14, व्हिच इज इक्वालिटी बिफोर लॉ। इट इज अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल ड्यू टू वायलेशन ऑफ आर्टिकल 25 एंड 26 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, व्हिच टॉक्स अबाउट राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजियन। इट इज अपोजिंग दैट राइट। इट इज अगेंस्ट फेडरलिज्म एज लैंड एज स्टेटेड द सेवेंथ शेड्यूल ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज ए स्टेट सब्जेक्ट। इन सरदार सैयदना ताहिर सैफुद्दीन साहेब वर्सेस स्टेट ऑफ बॉम्बे 1962, द सुप्रीम कोर्ट रूल दैट स्टेट शुड नॉट इंटरफेयर इन द मैटर्स ऑफ रिलीजियन। दिस बिल इज डिवाइसिव, द बिल इज एंटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल, द बिल इज एंटी फेडरल, देयरफॉर आई स्ट्रांगली ऑब्जेक्ट टू द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द बिल।
श्री श्रीमती के कनिमोजी।
Thank you, sir. It's a very sad day in Parliament today. This year, when we came back to the Parliament, many of the members took their oath with the Constitution in hand. That was to protect the Constitution, to imply that the Constitution is supreme and it has to be protected. But today, we see that this government is blatantly going against the Constitution. This bill is just not against the Constitution, it's against federalism, it's against a religious minority, it is against human beings. It shuns justice in every possible way. The bill violates Article 25 and Article 26 of the Constitution, which says we have the right to follow a religion and the rights of the religion to follow and manage its own religious affairs. Yes. The bill allows non-Muslims to be a part of the workforce. Like many people here have raised a question that will it be possible for a Muslim or a Christian to be part of the board which manages a Hindu temple? Yes. Would you allow that?
No, also Sikhs.
And Sikhs?
Parsis.
Parsis.
All minorities.
Would you allow that? No. But then, why should somebody who does not believe in a particular religion have the right to make decisions on behalf of that religion? Is this not unfair? Is this not against the law of justice? And it is a direct violation of Article 30 of the Constitution, which deals with the minorities to administer their own institutions. You're bringing others, now you're giving the right to decide whether the property belongs to the government or the work board, the collectors, and then another committee above them will be deciding whether the land or the property belongs. And we know already many old mosques are in danger today.
Yes.
Suddenly there is a PIL and people are sent, archaeologists are sent there, and they discover that it was a temple before this. And then there is hate, division, issues among the people of the country. It is happening.
Why?
this bill is specifically targeting a particular community, a particular religious group, and it violates Article 14 of the Constitution, which says equality before law. And it is omitting Section 40 of the existing bill, which deals with the powers of the work board to decide whether a property is the work board property or not. So this bill is completely against the Muslims, the minorities, and they does not believe that this country is made of people. It's a secular country. It is made of people who have different kinds of belief, different languages, different ethnicity, and different religions. This bill will destroy what our forefathers dreamt India should be. I oppose this bill. Thank you.
Rajiv Ranjan ji.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, कई माननीय सदस्यों की बात सुनी है।
This is not JDU is a party here. JDU is a party here. Whether it is opposing or supporting, I have to record my view.
बोलिए
अध्यक्ष महोदय, कई माननीय सदस्यों की बात सुनने से ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे यह जो संशोधन लाया गया वक्फ बोर्ड के कानून में, यह मुसलमान विरोधी है। कहां से यह मुसलमान विरोधी है? कौन सा इसका कानून मुसलमान विरोधी बताता है? यहां उदाहरण दिया जा रहा है कि अयोध्या की मंदिर गुरुबाई, अरे मंदिर और संस्था में अगर अंतर आपको नहीं समझ में आ रहा है तो आप कौन सा तर्क खोज रहे हैं? अरे ये मंदिर नहीं है, आपके मस्जिद को छेड़छाड़ करने का प्रयास नहीं किया जा रहा है। यह एक कानून से बना हुआ संस्था है, उस संस्था को पारदर्शी बनाने के लिए कानून बनाया जा रहा है। पारदर्शिता होना चाहिए। कोई निरंकुश संस्था कोई भी कानून से, वक्फ बोर्ड कैसे बना? वक्फ बोर्ड किसी कानून से बना है, और कानून से बना हुआ कोई भी संस्था अगर निरंकुश होगा तो उसमें पारदर्शिता लाने के लिए सरकार को हक है, अधिकार है कानून बनाने का। अब ये उसकी तुलना कर रहे हैं, ये तुलना कर रहे हैं मंदिर से। ये मंदिर से कहाँ उसका मतलब है? कोई धर्म के नाम पर बंटवारा नहीं हो रहा है, ये भ्रम फैलाना चाहते हैं। और ये बात करते हैं अल्पसंख्यकों की, अल्पसंख्यक की बात कर रहे हैं केसी वेणुगोपाल जी, अल्पसंख्यक की बात करते हैं। इस देश में हजारों पंजाबी सिखों को किसने मारने का काम किया था? किसने उसकी हत्या की थी? आपने की थी, आपकी पार्टी ने किया था। हम उसके गवाह हैं। हजारों सिख समुदाय, कौन सा सिख समुदाय? जो टैक्सी ड्राइवर था उसने इंदिरा गांधी की हत्या की थी। सड़कों पर घूम घूम के सिखों की हत्या कर रहे हैं और अल्पसंख्यक की दुहाई दे रहे हैं। भार। इसलिए इस बिल को आना चाहिए, पारदर्शिता आनी चाहिए। संस्था में कोई भी संस्था पारदर्शी तरीके से काम करे, यही मेरा आपसे आग्रह है।
श्रीमती सुप्रिया सुले।
Sir, I stand here on behalf of the NCP vehemently requesting the government either to withdraw the bill completely. That is our request to this government, because no detailed consultations have been done with these people who actually are running this organization today. So I request with full humility to this government to either withdraw it, and if they do not want to withdraw it, at least send it to a standing committee or make a committee together of the entire all party meeting and then do it. Please do not push agendas without consultations. I will not repeat a single point which earlier my kid, but the sad part is this, that we did not find about this bill from the parliament. We found out about this bill from the media. So is this the new way of this government working? Ki pehle media ko batayenge, fir parliament hoga. To hum padke parliament pehle media mein batayenge pehle. How? What is this new work of starting, sir? So you are insulting the parliament, the system and a democracy which we are also proud of. So our parliament has been undermined here. So you think we have no problem if you are leaking things to media? But don't do selectively. This office, this is a temple of democracy. We take our job very seriously. So please inform the parliament first before leaking it selectively to the media is my request. Sir, the other point is that you have deleted section 40. Yeah, yeah, please.
एक मिनट नहीं वो संसद में तो सर्कुलेट किया है ना इसको बिल को
इसीलिए वो कल
बट इट केम इन द मीडिया बिफोर दैट
बिल कल ही सर्कुलेट हो गया था
इट केम इन द मीडिया
ये जस्ट क्लेरिफिकेशन कर रहा हूँ
मीडिया कुछ भी
मीडिया के पास कैसे पहुंचा ये बिल नियम तहत लोकसभा सेक्रेटरियट में अपलोड होने के बाद मेरा पत्र जाने के बाद फिर अपलोड हुआ फिर कॉपी सर्कुलेट हुआ उसके बाद किसी भी तरीके से पब्लिक डोमेन में आने के बाद कोई
संसद ने
कल बीएसई में भी चर्चा हो चुके
हैं नो
कल बीएसई में सारे पार्टी के मेंबर्स बैठकर के चर्चा भी हो चुके हैं
देखिए माननीय सदस्य प्लीज प्लीज एक मिनट देखिए ये बिल सभी माननीय सदस्यों को सर्कुलेट किया गया है नो मैं तारीख सही बताता हूं अभी आपको एक मिनट में तारीख सही बताता हूं सर्कुलेट किया एक मिनट मेरी बात सुने सर्कुलेट किया सर्कुलेट करने एक मिनट सर्कुलेट करने के बाद बिजनेस एडवाइजर कमिटी के अंदर इस बिल के विषय के अंदर समय आवंटन हुआ ये सब आप बिजनेस एडवाइजर सब दल के नेता थे श्रीमती सुप्रिया सिले
Sir, the only concern is, sir, the only concern is this should not be a pattern because Parliament is supreme in a vibrant democracy like India. That's the only limited point I am raising here, sir. Sir, in section 3C, the collector issue which Kanni Mozi ji has raised, it's very, very worrying. A collector cannot take these decisions unilaterally. We vehemently object to that. Deleting section 40. Now, WAF is there or is not there is clearly needs to be done. You have deleted section 40, sir. It is not helping the cause, or I don't know what the intention is. If you are really bringing in transparency into a system, why are you deleting section 40 is my question to this. Then the WAF tribunal, it's completely weakened. The tribunal has no powers, because if anybody can challenge and go to the high court, then what is the role of the tribunal, sir? So this is a...
Please wait, you hear us.
Patience, yaar. Then there's section 108, section B. The rules will be made by the central government. Then what will be the rule of the states? The states, cooperative federalism, toh yeh sarkar bhooli gai. Har cheez mein, sir. Yesterday in the GST, we had the same issue. The Honorable Finance Minister gave us a very long reply, detailed reply, which I appreciate. But she is saying that nothing is, don't bring issues here, go back to the states. So then why are we elected here? Why do we have a parliament if for everything we have to go back to the states? And states ka koi sune toh na. That is the other problem. They say, write to the states. Then why are we writing to ministers here? It has no value. How can you undermine the central government? This is supreme, all state subjects. State GST, sir, I agree with you. But if in the GST council my minister doesn't come, what can I do? If we are not heard, how will it happen, sir? So my request is in 108 section B, the rules, states need to have their powers. Please do not take powers away. And equity before law. Sir, this country is about unity with diversity. Any country, well, look at what is happening in Bangladesh, sir. There is so much pain in Bangladesh. We are all very concerned about everything that's going on. So my thing is minorities should be protected in every country because they are lesser in numbers. So I think it's our moral duty to make sure, please, the government should clarify what is the intent of the government for and what is the timing. Aisa kya hua hai waqf board mein ki abhi aapko ye bill lana hai. Sir, we object. Please withdraw this bill. Let's have more detailed discussions. There are committees which are forming. Let's discuss it and only then bring a bill which is fair and which is just in this country, because in this constitution, every citizen matters and counts. That's what rightfully is given to every citizen, sir. Thank you.
माननीय सदस्यगण, एक बार फिर चेक कर लें, इस बिल को 6 तारीख को सर्कुलेट कर दिया था, आप पोर्टल पे चेक कर लें, क्योंकि आप सदन के बारे में, संसद के बारे में बोल रहे हैं, इसलिए मैं विषय को क्लियर कर रहा हूं। मैं आपने कहा कि ये बिल सीधा मीडिया में आया और हमें सर्कुलेट नहीं किया, इसलिए कह रहा हूं मैं आपको। मीडिया में क्या क्या बात आती है, इसके लिए हमारी जिम्मेदारी नहीं है। हमारी जिम्मेदारी इतनी है कि बिल सर्कुलेट 6 तारीख को हुआ है। एमपी अब्बू समदानी,
ईटी मोहम्मद बशीर,
नहीं नहीं आप बोलेंगे, बोले दोनों में से एक बोलेंगे, कोई बोलना नहीं।
Myself. Okay. Sir, thank you very much, sir. I vehemently oppose the very presentation of this bill. As correctly pointed out by my learned friends, this is a clear violation of the Constitution. It is a violation of the fundamental right enshrined in our Constitution. Article 14, Article 15, Article 25, Article 26 and Article 30. Sir, this bill is ill-motivated, sir. You have got dirty agenda with you.
Yes. In
sir, if this bill is passed, the entire boxing system will be collapsed, sir.
Shit.
That is going to happen. Similarly, sir, various bodies, work board and work council, all these bodies will have no existence. They will not have any value, because all the powers vested with these bodies are captured by the government and hand over to the district collectors. It's a funny thing, sir. Similarly, sir, this will spoil this secular nature of this country.
Yes.
Muslims cannot donate to the Hindu system and they cannot donate to work system. That is the restriction. Are you not ashamed of making this country in this way, sir? What is happening in this country? You have forbidden that kind of thing, sir. At the same time, this will jeopardize all the system. Now, worker board and council, if you go through that bill, sir, what is happening? They have no any power. All the powers are going to be vested with the collector. As per this act, collector is superior than the chairman of the work board, sir. That is the system we can see in this, sir. Sir, the funny thing is not that, sir. Once this bill is passed, the evacuation of the encroached property will become impossible. That is the funny thing, sir. This bill says that once government is encroached in this, government building is situated in the workforce land. Even after verifying, if that is cleared, then also it cannot be evacuated. So in fact, sir, you are encouraging encroachment on Waqf land. That is another thing, sir. Sir, sir, another thing, we can very well understand, powers of the Waqf administration, they will have no, this chairman and the Waqf board members, they will have no any power. In this various bodies, in the parent act, there was a clause. What was that? From various constituency members are there. There was a stipulation that there should be Muslims. But here you are saying only two names. That should be non-Hindu, non-Muslims. Even the name of a Muslim is not mentioned in this, sir. It means that you want to engross the entire system according to your liking. That is what has happened, sir. And we have to understand one more thing, sir. Government is trying to create a lot of injustice, sir. Because we had a lot of work. I have participated in 50th Lok Sabha. A JPC was constituted under Mr. Rahman our leader, community leader, Uma Khan, he made a wonderful report, sir. It was very clear. There was a lot of good thing. You are repealing all these clauses. After a lot of study, Rahman Khan committee recommended certain things and amendment was made accordingly. Now you are repealing all these clauses. So what I am saying is, you are cruel in this. You have to be sympathetic in this, sir. This legislation, you are killing, ruthlessly killing the system, the work system. I urge upon you to prevail wisdom. You must think about that. Don't poison this country in a different way. That is what you are doing. Your intention is to spoil this country's communal identity. What you are doing is, you are putting Hindus and Muslims in watertight compartment. You may have that desire, but we will not allow this country to go in that direction. Yes. Sir, with this word, I conclude. Thank you very much.
K. Radhakrishnan.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Sir, I strongly oppose the